Hello students, welcome to Easy Engineering. In this video, I am going to continue the controllers of proportional plus derivative. In the last video, I introduced you the controller and its various types. Among the types, what are all the types that we have holded in your syllabus, like PI, PD, PID, and we completed PI explanation also. So the description box gives you the link for PI controller. Those who needs the same, refer it. Then back to this video of PD controller. PD controller is a proportional plus derivative controller which produces an output signal which consisting of two terms. One is proportional to error signal and the other is proportional to derivative of the error signal. So that in PD controller, error signal E of t is proportional to E of t plus derivative, means d by dt of E of t. So that E of t equal to, by making an proportionality constant, proportionality gain Kp, so Kp E of t plus Kp into Td d by dt of Et, where Td is a derivative time. By considering this equation, we already have the Laplace transform, know the familiarities with a Laplace transform. So on by taking an Laplace transform with this equation 2.122, E of t becomes E of s, then Kp E of s Kp Td into d by dt of Et as S into E of S. That's why we have an expression for transfer function of PD controller, which is E of, rewriting this expression, we will get U of S by E of S equal to Kp into 1 plus Td into S. Then draw the block diagram of the same. Make the block diagram by having Kp into 1 plus Tds in a block. Input R of S, output E of S, then input to the controller is E of S and a feedback signal. It's very simple to draw, make a unique gain. Then what are all the points that we have to note it down in a proportional controller is, this proportional controller is effective only during the transient period, so that it does not produce a corrective measure for constant error. This is a disadvantage of a PD controller, or a feature of a PD controller. So how to use the PD controller and where to use it? So for using a derivative controller, it's never be used as an alone, in separate. Instead, we are using it in proportion with an integral controller. So this derivative control action is adjusted by varying the derivative time. Hence, this derivative controller is called as a rate controller. Now we'll see the effects of PD controller. This proportional controller block diagram just we completed. So we are all well known that the block diagram of a feedback controller, PD controller with the feedback. Feedback is make it as an unity. The open loop transfer function of the controller and we are drawing a closed loop system, so include g of s. Let the open loop transfer function of a second order system is well known for us, g of s equal to omega n square by s into s plus 2 tau omega n s. Now find the loop transfer function, means a closed loop transfer function is equal to g of s h of s into this open loop controller system g c of s, where h of s takes the value 1 unity. So our closed loop our open loop system of a PD controller along with a g of s becomes g c of s into g of s. We are well known g of s value. G of s value is kp into 1 plus here they are wrongly written in a book, I think. Yes, it is not td ti, it is t suffix d. Here it's wrongly printed in a, here it's td. Now everything correct here correct. You just make an corrections in your notebook. So gc of s equal to kp into 1 plus td of s into g of s. Into g of s is second order open loop system. Just make a simple multiplication and make it as a single expression. Now find the closed loop system. So finding a closed loop system is again very easier, because c of s by r of s equal to g c of s g of s by 1 plus g of s g c of s into h of s is already 1. So merely substituting and values, we knew the expressions. Now what we can do next, take an LCM here, so it becomes s plus 2 tau omega n s into s denominator side, then numerator's denominator, then denominator's denominator get cancelled. Then now make a further simplifications. Kp in the numerator side, kp omega n square into 1 plus td of s comes arrived as it is, then here multiplied with s, so it becomes s square plus 2 tau omega n s. Then multiply here in the bracket terms, kp omega n square plus kp omega n square t ds. Now we have make some arrangements for our further steps to proceed. Take this S term and this S term and take an S as a common one here. So now your expression becomes S square plus 2 tau omega n plus kp omega n square td into S plus kp omega n square. Then in a numerator side, here you multiply with kp, so omega n square here it becomes omega n square kp plus kp into td. So this kp into td, now we can write it as kd. So here it becomes kd into s. So that's it. We have completed a closed loop function of a PD controller. Then what are all the observations that we have made in a PD controller, and an important points to make it in our mind? By referring this expression, we know that PD controller introduces a zero in the system and increases the damping ratio. So while adding a zero, it may increase peak overshoot and reduce the rise time. So because of this, but the effect increased damping means damping ratio, it ultimately reduces the peak shoot. Then while observing an expression here, omega n square into kp into 1 plus tds by s into s plus 2 tau omega n, the PD controller does not modify the type of the system. Hence, this PD controller will not act modify steady state error. So this is a point that you have to keep it in your mind. Students, hope you can understand the PD controller. Keep on watching on consequent videos one by one and find the description for box for all the topics included in an first and second unit, especially, and follow the channel. In this description box, I provide you the PI controller which we have completed in the previous video. Thank you, students. Share the video to all your friends and support for an further academic sharing. Thank you.